Thank you again for this awesome opportunity. I just wanted to let you know that the students that you see in front of you, our school is in an area where there are 40 countries represented, 35 languages, and 72 dialects. So we really appreciate all of this beautiful diversity.
Yeah.
And in addition, we're a music conservatory, so you also see classrooms of little scholars and musicians. Mm-hmm. Having said that, I wanted to ask if you can give our students a word of encouragement, a word of hope, something that they can take with them, a charge as our future leaders and our future change agents. That would really be much appreciated. And again, thank you so much for your time. If you can give them a word of exhortation and hope.
Oh, yes, thank you. I'm very glad to know that you're such a diverse group of students there. And, you know, it's important to learn about each other from each other and not discriminate against people. And so you have the opportunity of being together through the school. And I hope that you will learn not only lessons that your teachers teach you, but lessons from each other. About you know, how you live and what you eat, and all of these little things make a very big difference, and that will help you as you grow up in being able to accept each other as human beings and not look at each other's you know, color and race and so on. And we need that kind of inclusiveness. We need people to respect each other and love each other, and it's only when we are able to do that and we can share with other people that we can really bring peace in this world. So, you know, I'm hoping that all of you will remember these lessons and grow up and think about them and make your lives useful. You know, as I told you, you should be in control of your life, and don't let somebody else waylay you on the way and mess up with your life. You got to be in control of your life. Don't succumb to anger and do something that will change the course of your life. Use your anger constructively and intelligently so that you can resolve the problem that caused the anger and not destroy your life in the process. You know, we see today our prison system is filled with young people who acted in a moment of madness. And now they regret it for the rest of their life. And that was because somebody provoked them and they did something stupid and their life was changed. So I hope that you will not be provoked by somebody and do something silly, but be intelligent so that you can make something out of your life. Like I said earlier, life is very precious, and we don't need to